You were expecting me, weren't you?
Oh, I am, Michael Cho. You better come in for a bit, you know, while I find my other shoe. Come in, love. Nice, isn't it?
It's lovely. It's beautiful.
And what am I doing, Shay Duckworth? Well, of course, I'm on the trail of one of the most popular characters of Britain's most popular television programme.
Oh, you could have had a cup of tea, Michael, couldn't you? But it'd have only been stewed.
Oh, that's right. All the more reason to get down to the Rovers, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Oops.
Lovely. How's that?
Right, then. Shall we be off, then?
I wish you could have stopped a bit longer, you know. Because I never showed you his pigeons, did I?
No, I'm sorry I missed those. You showed me lots of other things.
Well, I did. He's got lovely pigeons. Yeah, one of them, Dolly Parton. Oh, he thinks more of that pigeon than he does me.
Oh, I can't believe that.
And you know, we never miss your programme.
I never miss yours. We're here, listen.
Where?
You're going through the front. That's where you're expected.
That's right, love. And you're around the back, aren't you? Hey, watch your trousers on them dustbins.
That's 2:30, please, Derek.
Oh, thanks, Jack. And one for yourself.
Well, that's nice of you. Have half with you.
I'm celebrating, you see.
Oh, well, I'll celebrate with you.
Hey, you. Come here.
Mr. Wood have done. Beer that I am serving.
Yeah, well, I've just phoned the prison.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do I mean? I've just phoned them to see if I can see Artie as soon as possible.
What have you said to Lisa?
I haven't said out to Lisa. I'm not going to say out to Lisa.
I can't stand this anymore. I have to interrupt you, I'm afraid, because I've had a secret date with your wife, Jack, so that I'm here to say this book in my hand says William Tommy tonight. This is your life.
Gobsmacked. You sod.
Betty's going to put the towers over the pumps because we're going to pop along to a nearby studio here at Granada and tell the story.
He's got a funny
Well, yes, your real-life wife, Ali, here, was in on it too, and so were the rest of your family, including daughter Sarah and son Carl. And here is your other family out on parole tonight, your street son Terry, Nigel Pavara, his wife Caroline Milner, and the other stars of Coronation Street. Thelma Barker. Beverly Callum. Nicholas Cochran. Betty Driver. Simon Gregson. Jeff Hinsley. Kevin Kennedy. And Kirk Brown. Barbara Knox. Sarah Lancashire.
You look well.
Charles Lawson.
Your dress now. Take us later on.
Aren't we?
I am Michael.
Michael Lavelle. Deborah McAndrew. Philip Middlemiss.
I mean, man. Oh, my God. Look at this. Thing.
Ken Moore. Brian Moses.
Hello.
Bill Waddington. Sean Wilson.
You deserve it, pal. You deserve it, pal.
Hello, Helen.
Helen Worth. Liz Dawn. Julie Goodyear. And William Roach.
Thank you.
Well, Bill, your life in Coronation Street began in 1975. At first, your dulcet tones went unheard because you were a non-speaking extra playing darts in the Rovers. And then you spoke.
Oh, what?
Ernie's fingers.
Lie down, please.
Don't feel calm. God, mate, I'm sorry.
Oh, let me see.
I'm sorry.
Never play the piano again.
You're only supposed to say sorry once as well.
That was it, yeah.
Well, William Tarmy, this is your life, and it began not far from here in Ardwick, Manchester, on April the 4th, 1941. There you are, aged 12 months, with your late mother, Lillian, whose job was at the local tripe works. And there you are again, aged 3. That was shortly before your father, Bill Piddington, a wartime ambulance driver, was killed in action in Holland in 1944. Your mother married again to Bob Clueth here, and he's been dad to you since you were 5. The family home is at 41 Butterworth Street, Bradford, Manchester. School for you is at Bradford Memorial. There you are on the back row. And here is your best pal on the front row. You joined the boys' brigade together.
We did. Oh, right.
But he's still got a fine pair of lungs. Billy Taylor, an operator as well, Ian Ball.
Billy. How are you, sir?
How are you?
Yeah, you all right?
No, it's all right.
She's awesome.
Now, Billy, our Bill was also in the band.
It certainly was. I was a silver bugler.
Aye.
Bill was a silver drummer.
There he is.
Brave as a button stick.
It was the start of our interest in music, and we formed our own pop group. Remember?
Didn't we?
Ian, what instrument did Bill play?
Yes. Mum found it. It's the original harmonica that Bill played.
That is the actual one with your very spittle still in there.
Yeah, so that is the original, Bill.
That's it.
Thank you, Ian Ball and Billy
Taylor. Saxton full strength.
Now, when you leave school, you take up the same trade as your dad. Now, Bob, what was that?
It was a mastic asphalter. He won the best apprenticeship of the year. And me and his mother were very proud. But the proudest moment we had was when we both seen him on Coronation Street.
But he started as a mastic asphalt spreader. This is not easy to say. But one night with some pals, you call in at the Ebenezer Methodist Youth Club, and Ali, that's where you met, isn't it?
That's where we met, yes. We were both 14 at the time, and Bill invited me to go to his local church to the dance on a Monday evening, which I did. Turned up, found him sat there with another young lady. Got rather peeved about it. So as he was passing me, I gently sort of put my foot out, tripped him up and said, I think this is our dance.
Bloody kick me.
Well, it worked beautifully because you were engaged at 18. And married at 21 at Ebenezer Methodist Church on March the 17th, 1962. Well, back home, a whole new world opens up for the newly married mastic asphalt spreader.
What with posh china cups
and hot Sunday dinners
and all this on a building site.
Apprentices with you, Andy Cunningham, Tucker Cloran, and not met for 17 years, Tom Jones.
How are you? Thanks for coming.
So, lads, all this posh nosh was the influence of the new Mrs. Piddington, was it?
Yeah, certainly for Billy, but he got some stick.
Oof.
He didn't get the bruise then from now on.
What exactly happened then, Bill? What was done?
Actually, Ali being a lady and me being a pleb. Which is a little bit rough in the building trade. You don't go with china cups. And then they would be soap on the building trade. A flannel. And a little ornament that when you unwrapped it, it was a china cup. Well, the stick I took from these.
But still good friends. Thank you, Andy Cunningham, Tucker Cloran, and Tom Jones.
See you later, lad. See you later.
Well, as Billy Taylor mentioned, you played in a local pop group. You also sang in pubs for 30 bob, £1.50 a night. Now, Doug Worsley, you put him in for a talent contest and changed his name.
Yes, the name Bill Piddington wouldn't fit on the board.
No.
And there's always a touch of Mel Tormy about his singing, so Tormy to Tarmy didn't take long. And that name stuck with him since.
Yeah.
And it's at that talent contest that you met up with the band led by Mike Timoney. Mike, how did you rate Bill's singing then?
Well, we all thought he was a fantastic singer. And I think all the musicians here and all the musicians that ever worked with Bill will say he is a musician singer.
Jack Duckworth, the Sinatra of the street. Now, would your millions of fans believe it? We have the proof.
So lift us up where we belong, where the eagles cry on a mountain high. So lift us up where we belong, far from the world.
And that was from the album that you made with Mike. Now, William Roach, you're an admirer of that voice, I imagine.
Yes. Jack Duckworth sings the way you think Jack Duckworth should sing. That's out of tune and off key. And it's not easy for Bill whenever he had to do that. I've just heard Bill is a great singer, top professional singer, really great. In fact, there's only one voice amongst the cast that he's really jealous of, and that's mine.
Yes.
Hey, don't be rude. And in fact, what I don't understand, Bill, is that 10 years ago, you promised to give me some lessons, and you're still putting them off. I don't understand that.
But I heard your voice.
Yeah. Anyway, Bill, you're a good lad, you're very kind, you're house-trained, and we love having you around.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
But with your fine singing voice, Bill, little wonder that you got the job as resident vocalist and compere at Salford's Condren Club. You introduced many a star booking.
And one night, Bill, you gave me some on-the-spot advice.
It's Faith Brown.
Hello. Hello. How are you? I'm fine. How are you? You look great. You look tremendous. Oh. Do you remember the night, Bill, when I was, I had a very, very bad... We've worked together many times. This man's got the most amazing singing voice, as you all just heard. But do you remember the night when I had a terrible bad throat? Well, I had this awful voice, and I was terrified to go on. Do you remember?
Yeah. Hey, don't worry, son. Just stand there. You know, eyes down, look here, no problem. He said, stick your leg out there, you'll do it all right. And he said, knock him dead. And I tell you what, you've been knocking him dead forever. Thanks very much, Bill.
Thank you,
Faith Brown. Well, that club was just down the road from Granada Television, and you're happy to take work as an extra, not only throwing darts in The Rover's Return, but as a loyal servant of King Lear, played by Laurence Olivier himself in the TV production. Well, just as your career is getting underway, disaster strikes at the Well Green pub at Hazel Grove near Manchester in 1976. You were taken ill on stage. Mm. Your neighbour Dave Livesey was there, and Dave, what did you do?
Well, I drove Bill straight to Withenshire Hospital.
Fast.
Yeah, just a bit. Realising Bill was having a massive heart attack at the time. Yeah. And luckily, he's still with us. Thank God.
Well, Bill, you take 6 months to recover, but you throw yourself back into work with a band started by Jerry Jones here called Take Ten.
Yeah.
In October 1980, you're featured on a TV programme from Blackpool, Rising God. Stars.
Oh!
It's a family show, is it?
The way you haunt my dream. Oh, no, they can't take that away from me.
Oh, my God.
Now, I don't know if anyone else noticed, but it occurred to me that you might have put on a bit of weight then.
I was bordering on about 16 stone there, yeah. Yeah, when we did that, the dresser came in to see Harry and I, and we put the trousers on, and he said, it was a little bit twee, you know, and he said,
Flute Lovers, it's a family show, this. So, do you mind taking this, like, under your... So, of course, the voices went a little bit lower. Then I said, yes. All right, son, yes.
But a little bit higher when you sang.
It was funny, quite high, yeah.
Anyway, you slimmed down enough to be offered the part of Jack Duckworth in Coronation Street, and here you are thrown into the street literally.
Baby, no one up here. I've just got my head down.
Oh. Look, that's our furniture disappears in that van. Go sort it out. Hey, I'm coming to your flat.
Hey, hey, you're not taking our gear.
Look, I don't want any trouble, pal.
This will be all sorted out in a minute, this.
Because I'm only doing my job.
But the thing is, I put some gear in my house.
Yeah, see him off, Jack. Go on, belt him one.
Listen, you're right.
Yeah, go on, stick him on.
Will you shut up?
Lovely, Liz, lovely, lovely.
Well, that was a tender moment. Elizabeth Dawn, how would you have defined Vera's attraction to Jack Duckworth?
Well, I'm no Madonna. And I've never sucked his toe yet. But I love him. And we all love him.
As just about everyone knows, your old boss, Alec Gilroy, has gone to seek a new life on the cruise liners. But he has a message from the ocean wave, Roy Barraclough.
You know, Bill, working with you for the last 6 years was an absolute joy. You're a wonderful comedy partner and a hell of a nice guy. I remember you were the very first to make me feel really at home behind that Rover's bar. Have a super, super evening. Give my love to Ali and the family. God bless you, and I miss you, mate.
Well, thanks to Roy Barraclough, and look what happened when you became the street's hopeful Casanova with Bette.
Honest, I fancy you strong.
Could you fancy a cup of tea stronger?
Look, it's straight up this. I think you're a cracker, and I could go a bundle on you. I've studied here in Rovers, and we suit each other. We're the same kind of animal. And I think we'd be good together.
See? That was when I fell off the bed.
Was it?
It was when I fell off the bed.
Right.
I suppose that's a bit like Brief Encounter, wasn't it, that scene?
Well, it's the nearest he's ever got to twanging my elastic, I can tell you. But if we come to Bill Talmy for just a minute. When he first joined the cast of Coronation Street, do you remember Billy?
I do.
He was so nervous.
Nervous?
So we had to kid him that it was like a rehearsal all the time. It was never a take.
No.
He sweated blood, that lad. But he always came up trump. Bill Talmy, we all love you, and Ali, and Sarah, and Carl. Have a wonderful evening. You deserve it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Julie. Yeah. Bill, everyone here in Manchester knows your work. The charity is non-stop. You take underprivileged children on day trips with the Manchester taxi drivers. You raise funds for the Pat Phoenix-inspired Buy a Brick Cancer Fund with Helen Worth here. And you play golf for the charity Sparks. And that's put you in touch with your hero from the 1960s. And he's here for you tonight, Gordon Banks.
Wow!
How are you? You're looking great. Gordon, there was an extra bonus for Bill, wasn't there, in 1989?
Yes, there was that, actually. Bill turns out for a local charity team as well. And his son also plays in goal for the charity team. Bill was as proud as punch when Carl was voted as Footballer of the Year, as goalkeeper, by the way, for the by the All-Star team. And it was as though Bill, Tom himself, had been awarded a World Cup winner's medal. It's good to see you, Bill, and I think you've done a super job and I wish you all the very best indeed.
Good to see you, Bing.
Thank you, Gordon Banks. Now, Bill, there's another charity that's very important to you. When you had that heart attack at the age of 35 and later, when complications set in after the bypass operation, one man saved you. And he is here tonight, Withenshaw Hospital heart surgeon Henri Moussali.
How are you? You're looking well.
I'm glad
you're pleased with you.
Now, Bill required a quintuple bypass operation, wasn't it?
That's it.
And now you work together for a charity for the hospital called New Heart, New Start.
Your Heart, New Start. Now, one thing, ladies and gentlemen, you don't know. You know him as Jack Duckworth. You know him as Bill Tawney, the actor. I know him as a patient and as a person. As a patient, he has been marvelous. He has done everything possible to get better and to be as he is now. But as a person, now we are friends. And I can tell you what three things that he has. He has a kind heart. He is modest despite his fame. And let's face it, when I touched his heart and when I mended it, I knew that it was a heart of gold. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Well, Bill, you came back to achieve your lifelong dream in 1989. You made an appearance at Manchester's GMEX Centre, singing with the Halley Orchestra, no less, an evening of film and television music. It was attended by 10,000 fans. And here are four more, your grandchildren.
Hello, best pal. Hello.
Are you okay? Yeah.
Now, when Henri Moussali performed the operation that saved your life, you knew the risk involved. And Mike Timoney, he wanted to record a special song.
There was two of us sat in the studio, and we were watching him singing his track, and he was a very strange colour with his hands in his pockets, and we were thinking, maybe he's not telling us the truth. He was under-exaggerating. And he was not. He was dying while I was stood watching him singing. And he made me promise that there was one particular track that, if he didn't come out the other side of the operation, we'd dedicate to Alma. And maybe he might want to sing it tonight.
Well, perhaps you would. But before you do, I must say, Bill Tawney, this is your life.
Beneath my wings.